This is a chapter on master detail project where we shall be covering a project and we shall be going through all the steps for the implementation of that project. In the first lecture, let us see the overview of the whole project that we are going to implement. These are the prerequisites that you will need. In case you are not familiar with these, go through the previous tutorials to get yourself familiarized. The database diagram for this project will consist of a table for teachers and a table of their publications. This is a one-to-many relationship going from the email to the teacher ID. There will be an unique index on the ISBN, and you see these names of the columns pub underscore name, pub underscore date. These names plus this index plus this foreign key relationship plus the names of these tables, all these will be done with the help of model annotations, that is code first approach of generating the databases from the C# code. This is what we shall be learning in this project. When the project will open, a register teacher page will open. This page contains the list of a form where a new teacher can be registered. This pipe, I have shown here a link. This is a quick link to the list of all the registered teachers. This is a sort of a menu that I am using here. This is also one of the ways of writing a simple quick menu. This is written inside the H1 tag itself. The email ID of the teacher will go into the email primary key. The name of the teacher will go into the name column of the TBL teacher. There may be times when a user leaves this fully empty, or maybe there are conflicts of primary key. For example, if an email is already registered, a second email registration should generate a validation error. These validation errors for the required will be done with the help of server-side code. I will not be using the client-side code because that can be implemented with jQuery, HTML5, CSS and JavaScript and all that. We will be taking server-side validations with the help of C# code. This also we shall be learning. And as I already told you, if there are validation problems because of primary key violation, then also we shall be learning how to handle the database exceptions. And when an exception occurs, we shall also learn how to send a validation message to the user interface, like you are seeing here, account already exists. When a new teacher is registered, he is taken to the page where all the previously registered teachers are shown. This is a project that is just for the sake of it. So this is the list of all the registered teachers that we will be showing. Basically, this is the master table where all the registered teachers are appearing in a table. For each registered teacher, there is a publications link. This will take to the details page. This is again a menu that will take back to the registration form, and when you click here, you will be taken to the details page of this teacher. This email ID will also be sent to the next page. This email ID will also travel to the next page, and we will learn how to establish a communication between the previous page and the next page by sending data from one page to the next page. So when the publications link is clicked, we reach a page for publications of this teacher. And here is the list of publications shown. The date you can see, this is specially formatted. We will learn how to format this date. This formatting will again be done with the help of annotations. And just after this, a form is also shown. This form will be used to store a new publication. The name of the publication will go here. ISBN will go here. And the date will go here. And this teacher ID, the foreign key, will come from the previous page we will learn how to transfer data from the previous page to the new page. There may be validations for this also, and as usual, this required validation will come from the server side code. The date validation, the date requirement is that it should be back 20 years from the current date. For this, we will have to implement a custom validator. That also we will learn how to do. So this is all about the project that we are going to build. In the next few tutorials, we will learn how to carry on all the steps for writing this project. Thank you.